Gentlemen, welcome back to the Tiege Hanley Starting a Business, Building a Brand Vlog. This one, big number 205, and we got a special guest in the Tiege Hanley house today. This is Mike Levy. Mike Levy works for Pete and Pedro. He is my marketing director. He's been with me for how long now?
Almost a year and a half.
Year and a half. Formerly of?
Grooming Lounge.
The Grooming Lounge. You guys all, actually, funny story. Let's get a little comfortable and close to tell you a little story. Mike is actually one of the, and the Grooming Lounge was one of the first people to reach out to me when I was an influencer, I hate that word, influencer, a YouTuber. They reached out. What happened, Mike? Tell the story a little bit about how we came to know each other.
Reach out to Aaron. Aaron was super excited that...
But how long ago?
Oh, this is probably 10 years ago at this point.
Yeah, it was like 10 years ago. I had just like... And one more thing. I always get yelled at because I interrupt everybody whenever I'm talking to somebody. So I apologize in advance. It's going to happen. But keep talking, Mike. Yeah.
Reached out to Aaron. He was like, holy crap, this company's reaching out to me to do a little sponsorship. At the time, Aaron probably had 15, 20,000 fans. So that means, you know, it's a long time ago. And we put together one promotion, and it just was a home run, and we knew this guy was the man.
Early days, and that's one of the things that was so incredible. Mike had worked for the Grooming Lounge for literally 10 years.
10 years.
And so the fact that he saw this opportunity in this new platform, YouTube, and me specifically, because I was a content creator that was talking about grooming, he was kind of a pioneer. This was long before businesses typically were actually reaching out to YouTubers to talk about their products. And so you were one of the pioneers, Mike.
Love being a pioneer.
All right, so seriously, Mike has 10 years of experience in men's grooming e-commerce. Tell a little bit about your background in terms of, you know, sort of the Grooming Lounge and how it came to be that you teamed up with Pete and Pedro and convinced me to give you a shot.
Yep, well, and I got my MBA, came out of my MBA, and I had an opportunity to work for Grooming Lounge. And I was at Grooming Lounge, I spent about 10 years there, just kind of working on the online marketing and kind of figuring out what we needed.
May I interrupt for a second?
Yes,
see,
you can.
See, I asked, that was polite,
That was making it a little bit too long. Please dive in.
No, well, here's the thing, though. The Grooming Lounge, though, they were like the first people. This was before, like, Amazon was popular. The Grooming Lounge was like it. Like, it was the place where you went if you were a well-groomed man. If you wanted to find something, they had everything. And so this was like back in the day. And so you guys were like the first.
We were the first men's grooming website that really carried all the best of the best products.
And so for 10 years then, you worked with them and decided, you know what, it might be time to try your hand at another business.
Exactly. So, you know, I tried to take all my skills that I learned at Grooming Lounge and wanted to take on a new, different opportunity to help Pete and Pedro. And, you know, it's been an awesome year and a half. We've done some great stuff, and we got a good future ahead.
Yeah, and so this is one of the scariest things. Hiring Mike at Pete and Pedro is one of the scariest things. But we talk a lot on this vlog about hire people that are better at you at certain things. And with the company Pete and Pedro, don't talk about it all that much. I was good at promoting it, but I was horrible at everything else. I just want to do what I do, which is pitch and promote and do product videos and do YouTube videos. This is what I was good at. And Pete and Pedro was growing just because my audience was growing. And the way that Pete and Pedro works is you buy something, you try it, you like it, you buy it again. And so the business was growing despite the fact that I was doing nothing in terms of marketing. I wasn't doing anything in terms of emailing. And so when Mike came down, I realized that it was time to sort of toss the keys from a marketing perspective and let him basically do what needed to be done in terms of growing Pete and Pedro. Now, Tiege Hanley, different animal. From the beginning, of course, we started small, but right away we knew, yo, we got to hire people. We got to get people in the positions in order for us to grow and keep up with demand. Tiege Hanley is a larger business than Pete and Pedro. But Pete and Pedro, since Mike came on a year ago, you know, we were up about 30 to 35% this year over the previous year. So a lot of the strategies that Mike has employed has allowed us to grow because we were kind of, I mean, we were up, but we weren't like still like growing like crazy. And so you were going to say something?
Okay. Not yet.
Okay.
But I will.
Okay. So anyway. So today, Mike is down for some Pete and Pedro stuff. Next week, I'm headed to Chicago for the Tiege Hanley quarterly meeting, which I'm incredibly excited about. It's been too long since I've seen everybody. We're working on a lot of things, and we are getting ready to execute and execute and execute some really exciting things for you. And the vlog that I have in store for you next week, guys, it's really special, sentimental to me, and I cannot wait for you to watch it. And I'm so excited. Did I tell you he's going? Don't say.
No, you didn't.
Okay. So I'm so excited. Anyway, lots of great things are happening at Tiege Hanley. We are still figuring out, turning knobs, tweaking things to make sure that we continue to drive sales, but also retain customers. Some incredibly exciting things for you guys out there that are customers of Tiege Hanley. We've got our loyalty program, and it's kick-ass. You guys are going to love it. It's taken us too long to actually get that situated. But while I had Mike in town, I thought, you know what? He has done such a good job, and he knows internet marketing. And so I thought, you know, Mike, why don't you sit in on the vlog and go over some of the things that you know to do to help you guys that are starting e-commerce businesses grow your business. And so Mike has come up with a list. Five things?
Five things.
What are the five things? Like five top, like, marketing strategies for you to grow a monster successful business?
Stick to these five and everything else will come.
Everything else will come. All right, gentlemen. Let's get my coffee and then we'll start, okay?
Sounds good.
All right, gentlemen, so brace yourself. Prepare yourself for the secrets to be unlocked. Mike, take it away. Number one.
Number one, relentless customer service. Everything that you do should be all about your customer service. That's the backbone of your business. So make sure you're talking to your customers, getting back to them fast. If they have issues, figure out something that makes them happy. Whatever it is, whatever it takes, if your customers are happy, then they're going to come back, tell other people, and your business should do well.
So that is one of the things that Tiege Hanley has figured out very early that Pete and Pedro and myself did not figure out. Like, when I was starting Pete and Pedro, it was back in like 2013, I was of the mindset like, what, you don't like it? Screw you. Like, I was not very customer service oriented. It was actually my mom that was like, you can't do that. You've got to really, you know, take care of your customers. And so since then, everything has sort of changed. But Tiege Hanley has done an amazing job. We've got a great customer service team at Tiege Hanley, like second to none, like best in class. And so, you know, customer service, number one thing that you've got to remember, guys. The customer isn't always right, but they can't know that. You got to do what you can do in order to make them happy. Because even if your customer is pissed off, if they have a good customer service experience, they might not ever buy from you again, but they're not gonna trash you and talk shit.
That's good.
Number two.
Number two, less is more. So two things that you probably don't have a lot of when you're starting out are time and money. So focus your energy on the couple things that you know work and go after them with all your force. So if you're, you know, big on YouTube, put all your energy in YouTube. Don't do YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, email, and every other possible marketing idea that's out there. You just don't have the resources, so go after a couple of them and pound those as hard as you can.
Exactly. That's something, another one that I had to learn the hard way, you know, because, you know, so often I think as entrepreneurs, you hear about the newest, latest, greatest. It's like, it's TikTok, it's this, it's that, and are you here, and are you doing LinkedIn, or, and like, there's so much out there that I have had to sort of pull back and acknowledge the fact that I'm not great at certain things, but I'm really good in certain areas. And so that's something that you just need to be honest with yourself. You can't be great at everything, but be great at a few things and you're gonna be a lot more successful, right?
Exactly.
Number three.
Number three is email is still king. So you wanna make sure that you're...
Define email, what does that mean?
Email marketing. So you want to, you know, make sure your list of all your customers is well managed. When you send out emails about new products, updates, holiday deals, or whatever it may be, you want to make sure that your emails have everything that you want to promote, but also make sure they have a ton of value. Emailing just the email is not the best thing that you can do and annoys the customer. And you also want to make sure that on your website you're capturing people. So, you know, when they get to the website, you're going to have a lot of new traffic. You got to have the pop-ups and any other resources that gets their email to sign up, so you get them in your funnel. So get them in the funnel, and then you can market to them, because most times it takes five to 10 times for a customer to actually purchase something. So that first time you see them, that's just the first touch point. You gotta build up the trust.
It's all about that email, gentlemen. We've talked about it before. That email, when that customer gets to your website, you've got to have something that will incentivize them, like, ooh, I'd like to give them my email address. Like, it's called like a lead magnet. A lot of times, websites will have some type of lead magnet or multiple lead magnets.
Right.
And so it's critical because that email address is allowing you to market to those people. And if they gave you their email, that means that they're very warm. Not just they've been to your website, they were not only to your website, they're willing to give you their email address. And that's something that is very valuable. And so when you do an email blast, you know, that has like a good offer or some type of incentive, all of a sudden, like, they're like, it's amazing. In terms of a sales spike, it's ridiculous. And so, you know, email is still king. Now, Mike, what is the best service would you recommend somebody who's starting out to manage their email list?
If you're starting small, you can always go with like a MailChimp. Pete and Pedro, we used Klaviyo. You
know, T. Shanley, we use Klaviyo as well.
So as your business grows, you probably want more robust services. You know, so, you know, obviously how much do you want to spend and how many customers are on your list will determine what you want and what you're doing. But, you know, start small, grow it out, and then you can always upgrade to better services.
Here's something that most people don't realize, that when you have a massive email list, it's very expensive. Like, it's expensive from a monthly expense standpoint. And so a lot of times, it's a good idea to sort of like scrub your email list so that you're not paying for people that never open their emails or that are dead email addresses. And you have the ability to do that with your email list.
Yeah, and email is still the most effective ROI. So, you know, you can have all the other advertising and all the other things out there, but at the end of the day, if you pound your email, you're going to get your best bang for your buck.
Your marketing buck. Number four, Michael.
Number four is super easy. Get reviews. So those early
products. That's not easy.
It's not easy, but if it isn't easy. But, you know, if you're launching a new product, you really got to get those first five reviews onto the website. So whatever service that you're using, really make sure that you're getting reviews, both positive and negative, so that when new customers come to your site, they see the feedback from it. So really focus on using a review service because it can literally make the difference. And there's also there's nothing wrong with getting negative reviews because those negative reviews actually can help build trust sometimes because people see that it's not the perfect product sometimes. Sometimes it's the perfect product for you, but it might not be the perfect product for him.
Exactly. So talk a little bit about the different services that are out there in terms of reviews.
Yeah, I mean, you can use a variety of services. We're about to use Yotpo for our reviews. We're currently using JudgeMe. And
what's the difference and why would you go with one versus the other?
Yotpo has full functionality. It has one of the key things for reviews is the Google shopping. So if you go onto Google, type in, you know, best hair products or best skincare boxes out there, you'll see that products have star rating by them. So those stars obviously build trust. When somebody sees 1,000 reviews for a product, they're way more likely to click on it than if they see it has 10 or none. So most people, or most brands might not have a good review service that's not giving them the stars. So
On Google.
Plus they have SEO, organic help, and they also have better filters. And there's a variety of other functions that they can do that integrate with their email for feedback and other things.
Okay, good. So guys, we live in a world of reviews, right? We are looking towards other people, our peers, to tell us what they think of our products. And in that world, this is another reason why you need to have amazing customer service. Because a lot of times, like, you actually might get like a negative review, and if your customer service is strong and actually goes after those people to say, hey, what's the matter, or how can we help you, or what, you know, can we change? A lot of times they will change the review, right?
They will change it, and don't be afraid to email also your most positive guys too, because those are the guys who already love your products, and they're the ones who are more likely to try your other things as well. A lot of times we only focus on the negative guys, but at the end of the day, the five-star guys are actually going to be your best customers and more willing to try other things as well.
Love it. All right, last but certainly not least, the fifth secret to marketing domination is
conversion optimization.
What does this mean? It sounds so scientific.
It's not that complicated, but it might actually be number one. So
okay, that's number one. I thought customer service was number one.
Customer service is number one, but it could be number one. 1A.
You can interchange one or two. Okay, 1A and B. Go ahead.
Everybody loves more traffic, but the problem with more traffic is it means it usually costs more money to get that traffic. What you really should be asking yourself is, what can I do to convert the traffic that I already have to get these guys placing orders? So there's a variety of conversion techniques that you can do, whether it's A/B testing or heat maps, or just playing around with your websites with your drop-downs and a variety of other tools.
Pop-ups as well.
And pop-ups as well, getting them in the funnel. But basically, there's probably 10, 15 different things that you can do, rearranging your website, that you can get guys to convert much stronger. And it's really, at the end of the day, it's all about conversion percentage. You know, so if you're getting that high percentage, then you know you can keep on marketing and pushing the dollars that way.
And if you can figure out that conversion and get your conversion rate high, then it makes a little more sense to pay and get people to that website. But until you figure out and really nail down the conversions in terms of getting people to the website and actually converting them to a sale and not having them bounce, you don't want to spend a ton of money just to get these people, because it's expensive to get traffic and they don't convert. And so it's kind of like, Your conversion rate goes down, and you're just spending a ton of money on traffic.
Exactly, yeah. So you could have a million people to your website, but if nobody's buying, what's the point? So figure out what makes people convert. Then once you get that answer, then you can move forward with everything else.
The other thing is something that most of you have all experienced. When you don't buy something and you add something to your shopping cart, you know, there is another like email sequence that will go after you, and the ability to sort of close the deal after you've already left. There are even things where when you go and put your mouse, like you're going to X out, a pop-up will show up like, hey, how about giving us our email for 20% off, 10% off? So there are all sorts of incentives and ways for you to try to actually close that sale before that person actually leaves.
Yep, those are called browse abandonment, shopping cart abandonment. And retargeting. So those are key, crucial online marketing techniques that basically are also your best return on investment.
All right. I love it. Good job.
That's all the five I got.
They're pretty solid.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, that is, I can't believe how fast time goes when I've got somebody helping me with this. Mike, any last words to the gentlemen? These are entrepreneurs, potential entrepreneurs in the future that are amazing, you know, people that are here, that are engaged, that are thinking about possibly starting a business, or they're interested. Do you have any words of advice to them?
Just do it. You'd stick to it and give it a shot.
Is it easy?
It's not easy. I don't do it. I follow you, but give it a shot, man. That's all. This is the time to do it. And it's more opportunity than ever. And, you know, good luck.
Good luck. I think that's where we're going to wrap it up. Gentlemen, if you have a business question, down in the comments, start it with business question and then ask your question. Next week, we're not going to get to your business questions, but the following week when we're back in Atlanta, I am actually going to go through and make it all about your business questions, because the last few weeks I've kind of sucked a little bit in that regard. There also haven't been a ton. But guys, if you've got a business question, down, ask it, because this vlog is all about you. It was great having Mike here. Another time we're going to get Akin, because Akin has another wealth of information and knowledge. He does things a little bit different. He has his hands in different things that Mike does not. And so Akin is another one. He is a rock star in the marketing digital space. And so we're going to get him on here and help answer some of your questions. But at the end of the day, I just said at the end of the day, I'm not allowed to say that.
He loves that. I know.
I love that saying. I think you said it once in this one. We love you more than our double monk strap shoes. And this vlog is about you. It's about being a resource to help you in your entrepreneurial journey. Gentlemen, it's not easy, but let me tell you something. There is nothing sweeter at the end of the day. See,
That was okay, though.
That one was okay?
That was okay, because it actually ended the video.
Guys, we love you more than our double monk strap shoes, and we'll see you in Chicago. Bye. Good job.
Yeah.